Good afternoon, ladies and gents. Welcome back to the channel. This is probably not the best idea vlogging while on the motorway. I haven't got hold of the camera. It's still an added distraction, but it is what it is. Hopefully I don't crash, famous last words and all that. But a much later start to the day than planned. It's currently gone 1 o'clock. Had a very late start to the day with being a bank holiday and not having to be in work. Went for breakfast with Kelly and her family. Went to good old Wetherspoons. Had a small breakfast there, and I can be very OCD with pre-training stuff, which I plan to train today, and that was sort of a kind of last minute, she let me know. But on the way to wake up, walk, coffee, breakfast, coffee again, and then head to the gym. I like to have my usual oats, protein, do the usual protein oats. Don't know why I just didn't say that in the first place. So it's gonna be interesting to see how we get on in training today. Speaking of, my legs are still very sore from Friday's session and Saturday as well with Kelly at the David Lloyd. Just a little upper body session with some conditioning in there. But I think because it's been a bank holiday weekend and today feels like a whole weekend's felt like a Sunday, and today feels like a Sunday as well, so my body's just a bit all over the place. But hopefully the coffees I've had kick in by the time we get to the gym, and hopefully this pre-workout does its job and able to get in the zone and hit some heavy squats and deadlifts.
Facts.
I think for
Cats it's a really, really good idea, because imagine if we just had Minnie, she would have passed out by now with the fit.
Like, I tried an intro two or three more times, but I just couldn't get the words out. It seems that once I've filmed the clip, my brain just doesn't want to say the words again. But we are back at Vault today. I didn't want to go to Pure Gym on the drive over, because I thought that would be closer to home, but it turns out it was only about a 5 minute difference, so I decided to come back here. I obviously gave a bit more time for the coffee and caffeine to kick in, which it's done its job. I'm certainly feeling a lot more awake. Done a few world sets and I've realised I've left the tripod attachment in the car. I can't bother going back to get it, so you're on the little GoPro one, so all the angle's going to be low for these lifts, unless I do decide to run outside and grab it. But it was raining when I got here, so can't bother going on getting me shoes without changing, so that's what it's going to be for today. Low angles today, but warm so far, feeling okay. Right shoulder's playing up, it's very tight from I think probably all those devil's press on Friday, but it's loosening off slowly, so I'm taking my time. It's also nice not having to rush to get these squats done, so I've got no PT today. But fingers crossed we can get up to 152 and a half with no problem and then get through all three sets of five. It was very nice indeed not having to rush through the session, as the extra time was much needed for the warm-ups and to get more in the zone for heavy squats. I just couldn't quite get in the right frame of mind for heavy squatting. And I've only just noticed the shallow boxer behind me looked like he was punching my glutes before I went into the set. But these squats felt surprisingly strong. Again, during these sets, I felt like my hamstrings and glutes were doing the majority of the work. I'm not sure if that's because they were fatigued from Friday and Saturday, so they're having to work a little bit harder, or I was just squatting slightly differently because I was really thinking about sitting back a lot more, which I'll have to do since switching over to these slippers. This set from this angle, again, that wonk is starting to appear. Bottom of the squat, that's kind of sort of twist a little bit to the right, and that right side sinks down. Again, all stems from that right shoulder, but weight through the feet felt pretty even, and these were feeling very strong out the bottom. As you can see, I'm in a decent depth. Again, really thinking about sitting back. Again, getting those hamstrings and glutes to do a lot of the work. And surprisingly, the quads felt pretty fresh, which was very strange. Then the final set. Again, I was just struggling to get in the zone before these sets, but when it was on my back, the unrack felt nice. Speaking of racks, staying in the Hyrox area, because these racks can be set at a much nicer height, whereas over in the squat area, that was full, no surprise, bank holiday. I felt like I had to tiptoe to unrack and rack the bar, but they were two-sided, so I don't know if I was just using the wrong side, but these squats all felt very nice, and I feel like I can still hit some progress with these, adding 2.5 kilos each week. Although I'm thinking last week will be the last week of straight sets before moving to just one top set of five, or do I milk this for as long as I can? There were definitely some minor amount of squats, but all felt pretty solid despite the fatigue, and we're gonna stay over here for the deadlifts. because they are bumper plates here, and I just thought it might be good to be hit moving over to metal plates, because they are definitely much heavier. I don't care what people say. Obviously it's because of the physics. And being like a thinner plate in the centre of gravity. Closer to you, rather than the fat plate, it's gonna be further away. And also I want to use these because I can use three reds on each side, which will be again another little boost for the mind. So it'll take a few minutes, get warm, and then get into tennis. Feeling more confident about tennis now that the heavier squats are out the way. Apologies for all the low angles today, but we're just about to go into the top set of deadlifts with top weight, rather than top set, it's getting four. Which we set to 3 and 1, 2.5. But while looking for my headphones in my bag, I forgot I had. Where's it gone? I've lost it already. I found this little cream egg in the shows. This is a bad angle to get the light from. So I told myself if I hit all three sets of three, I can just cream egg after training. Also, it's probably a bit of a stupid reason to do it, but also hamstrings are feeling a little bit tired after squats, so I'm gonna see how they get on with these and then probably chuck in some more direct hamstring work, some leg curls after the split squats, or just scrap split squats and just go straight for the hamstring curls, because they do often get neglected, so they get hit now on their lifts and when I run, which obviously isn't much of a resistance movement, not just fatigues, and so I'll probably chuck in hamstring curls, spend it on fear, and hopefully get that green leg after all three sets. I was definitely saying the wrong thing, saying my hamstrings were tired, as they almost felt activated in a way, because these deadlifts felt very strong off the floor, and hamstrings were just fine, so these look very comfortable for all three sets, really. Again, working on keeping those legs a little bit lower, trying to use the quads more to break the bar from the floor. Back angle is slowly getting better. This one doesn't look too great. I just find that belt position doesn't add to it, and I had very prominent erectors, but felt pretty strong. That left hamstring was a little twinge like I had the previous weeks, but nothing too concerning. I was able to get through the second set and the third and final set here quite comfortably. So pleased with these. Again, same with squats. Not sure whether to try and get as much out as I can, adding 2.5 kilos each week, or drop down the volume and up the intensity for one top set with maybe one or two back-offs as we switch things up after next week and following weeks at deload. That's the cream egg end, although you shouldn't have to end your food. That's probably a terrible thing for me to say. I don't condone it. You should just eat what you want within reason. But yeah, surprised with them. Lower back felt a bit funny on the last set, but again, it's put down to fatigue and the hamstrings, and it's just absolutely fried. But now on to split squats. Gonna up the weight and drop it down for 8 reps, so 3 or 4 sets of 8 on each side, and then onto some more isolation work, so some hamstring curls, and then maybe chucking some extensions because my quads don't feel like they've worked at all today. Or obviously some back work, either the bench row or cable row, depending on what's free. I always find it quite surprising how, depending on where you hold weight, how difficult the exercise is. This is 220 kilos, one each hand, so 40 kilos altogether. The past few weeks, I've been doing the goblet squats, holding it in front of my chest with 30 kilos, and that's felt like a struggle, but these felt super easy. Might have just been having the back foot on the bar rather than on the bench, but felt super easy. And then I thought I was missing, which was obviously rollouts, but I supersetted those in for dead bugs. So we did 3 rounds of 8 each side on the split squats and 3 sets of 15 each side on the dead bugs before moving on to the hamstring work. This machine was a bit interesting to figure out. The knee pad moved around so you could support that as the other leg did the work. I thought that pad was for the working side. It took a little minute, but kept things very light. Just did, I can't remember how many did, 12 reps each side, nothing crazy, 3 sets. Get a nice contraction in hamstrings, get those firing. They didn't need much weight after the squats and deadlifts. And then, because I thought why not turn it into a bit of a bro leg day, and did some leg extensions, just 2 sets of max reps with, I believe, 15 kilos on each side. It's probably my favourite leg extension machines because it works unilaterally. Just, I think, 15s on each side. And then to finish off, this is a gym pin for the row. You can adjust where you put the cables to make it wider or as narrow as you want. I was going for a semi supinated row, just hit those mid back more as I feel that's a neglected area. And then a few sets of that, and then
that was it. Job done. Monday training's finished.
And as per usual, that session was a lot longer than intended, but the energy just hit me. I just felt good, so I just kept on going. Although I'm probably gonna regret it later on in the week. And surprisingly, I need to stop getting so obsessed with having things regimented. I said this before, normally I'm just sort of freaked out about not having the usual breakfast, because today I had, like I said, scrambled egg on toast rather than the usual oats. But I would like to get away from that sort of such a strict mindset towards food and pre-workout foods. Obviously, I'm still gonna be sensible with my pre-workout choice. I'm not gonna have like a pizza or burger or something stupid, but eggs seem to sit well, like eggs on toast or eggs in a bagel. I used to have eggs before I lifted back on the years, about 8 years ago when I was weightlifting. But I've got this habit of oats and everything being very regimented, which I need to break that. It's not necessarily a bad thing, but it can just have a knock-on effect for the day. But very good session, pleased with how everything felt. And I think, like when I broke down the program last time, I've got one more week of pushing, and then I've got a deload week, and then 5 week block deload week. So I'm probably gonna drop down to one top set with one or two back-offs on the squat, deadlift and bench. And then just see how long I can progress with that until about 12 weeks out, and then drop them and just focus on high rocks. So right now, I'm just heading home for a quick late lunch, early dinner. I'm gonna snack on the well-earned cream egg, and then maybe, depending on, I've dropped my cream egg, so I'm probably gonna have to search for that. And then maybe head over to Kelly's with Odin so he can meet Lyra. If not, I'll probably do that later in the week, but they will definitely meet. So yeah, it's how long it takes to get home and then decide when we are there. Third time looking for this. I just recorded it a second time because the lighting was bad, only to realise the microphone had come out of its socket, so that means it's for your headphone users, it would only be out one ear, which even when I'm editing it just doesn't sound right, so that fixed that. But very good session, and something I need to not obsess over, or I found myself obsessing over, is trying to get my videos edited and done by certain times, like 6 p.m. Whereas right now it's just gone 10 past 5, and I've not done the voiceover for the previous vlog, excuse me. I can sometimes start stressing about that when I think within the hour it should be fine, or even the next day. I just like having the structure of Monday, Wednesday, Friday being the videos. But then sometimes I just procrastinate too much and leave it too late. Anyway, brain needs sugar. So I've got a bit of a mixed match for lunch. Got a cinnamon raisin made, which I'm halfway through, well, quarter of the way through, with some blackcurrant jam and some pink Himalayan sea salt. And then got a peri peri chicken sandwich. And then while it was all being toasted, I had a sausage roll, just chucking in the microwave for like 30 seconds because I had that breakfast at like 11-ish. It's been way too long since that. And since now it's sort of between what's closer to dinner time and lunchtime. I'm having this, which is, I'm probably just have a bowl of cereal with some protein in the milk. And then from tomorrow, get back on it with the nutrition, have a proper structure, start tracking again. Start making sure I'm eating enough and have the right things, and that'll help my performance and recovery going forward. So I'm gonna enjoy this and then head over to Kelly's with Mr. Odin. Either that today or tomorrow. So we'll jump to that right now.
He just wants to be your friend. He's a nice boy.
Well, that went better than expected. It was very stressful half an hour for Odin, but it was very promising. I think we're going to start taking him over once a week, just to get used to each other. Maybe take his bed over as well, so we can get used to the smell. But Very promising indeed. Mother Odin's absolutely knackered and passed out downstairs. About half an hour with them together. Took them for a walk and then another sort of 10 to 15 minutes together, and she was definitely a lot better. But that's going to be it for today's video. I've just downloaded Warzone on the laptop, so I'm going to try and figure out the settings. The controller doesn't seem to use the right stick, or doesn't pick up the right stick, which is interesting, so I need to try and figure that out. And it's set my ranking back to zero, which is great. But anyway, yeah, that's it for today's video. Next one will be upper body session tomorrow over at Vault. Looking forward to that with some conditioning. So if you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you are new, smash subscribe, turn notifications, all that jazz. And as always, I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.